airworthiness in Hyderabad just a few moments back, and he said that quite recently the airworthiness certificate of this helicopter, VT-APG, which is the Bell 430 helicopter in which the Chief Minister was flying, that has been recently renewed. But there are still questions which remain on the airworthiness of this aircraft in the past, the safety standards or the maintenance standards which were maintained. The DGCA's website quite clearly indicating that there was a period of time when the aircraft didn't get its CFA, as it's known, its Certificate of Airworthiness, renewed for a period of 2 years. But at this stage, we can say that according to the DGCA, the aircraft, when it was flying, was made airworthy.
Right, very reassuring. Also ties in what our correspondent, Sandeep Phukan just told us. Vishnu, thanks very much. Meanwhile, the Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister's chopper, of course, has had absolutely no contact with anybody. Time now really running out. It's almost 6 in the evening. This is virtually the end of daylight, and it had the Chief Minister, the Special Secretary, Chief Security Officer and two pilots on board. No word from any of them. In fact, there are serious concerns and more questions than answers. Is the Andhra Chief Minister safe? As you can imagine, that is a big worry. Has the chopper crash landed in bad weather? This, of course, the chopper is believed to have come down in the forest of Kurnool. Very dense of forests here, and the weather really not helping any situation. In fact, rescue missions also had to be abandoned because of bad weather. The other question, if he has landed, why can't he or one of the co-passengers or pilots, for that matter, make any contact with the outside world, tell them where they are and the help that they might need? The big worry. This is a Naxal-infested area, and there are serious concerns, not just there in Andhra Pradesh, but also here in Delhi, that the Naxals might have stepped in. Is the Chief Minister free, or has he been captured? That, of course, is really, really a big cause of concern at this stage. Did the Chief Minister land deep inside the forest, which is why they're not able to go out, or are they in a tiny, isolated part of the forest? As you can imagine, that if you're not familiar with a part of the forest, it might just be very difficult to leave. It's been almost 8.5 hours, no word from the Chief Minister or anyone who was with him on that chopper. There were reports that the chopper in fact was not airworthy, but they've just been denied. They in fact had met all tests, and all stringent tests had been carried out on them, so that according to the DGCA, the Director General of Civil Aviation, doesn't stand. The air search, of course, is underway. Choppers have been pressed into service. Ground operations are also on, since air search will not last beyond daylight. In fact, daylight now running out, ground operations underway. There will be unmanned aerial vehicles that the Air Force will send into the forest. They have night vision capabilities, but of course, there's only so much that an air search can do. Now, as the Andhra Pradesh government has also appealed to people living in the area to come out and help them with any information they might have on the Chief Minister. We slip into a quick break. The big story we're tracking.